think that they don't know how to manipulate us. So we, when we were scientists, when we had labs, when we were gene splicing and we created what is known as the European, we were into taking man and making God. They have the power of taking God and turning him into man. They're reverse engineering us. That's what we're seeing right now. So don't talk war around me. I don't even want to hear you niggas talk war, because you're not war ready. I don't think so. You need more people. I don't really see it. These niggas want to pray. They want to cry. You know what I mean? They want to apologize. They want to hands up, don't shoot. They want to wave white flags. They want to get on. They want to buck dance. They want to do everything but buck. All right, but they're going to buck on me, and they're going to buck on him, and they're going to buck on each other, and they're going to buck on their mama, and they're going to buck on their papa, because they got mommy daddy issues, but they won't buck on these motherfuckers that got their foot and their hand up their ass. At the end of the day, what are we going to talk about? What is there to talk about? The only people that I'm willing to talk to at the end, right now, at this point in juncture's time, is people that are vibrating at a frequency akin to mine. Not even niggas calling themselves conscious, because that's not even enough. A lot of them niggas is co-opted and birded out. You understand what I'm saying?
Okay.
Black Lives Matter is a fucking op. You know what I mean? A bunch of homo-ass niggas running around taking money, robbing from my people, stealing from my people. You know what I mean? Pump faking, Twitter finger ass niggas. Where they at right now in North Carolina? Where they at? Where was they at in Flint? With all of the, they remember they secured the bag. They had it. What happened to Flint?
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Why
whoa.
Did they get the people water? Huh?
Yeah.
How were they not helping the homeless? How are they not helping the, why are they not in Chicago? They burnt an 11-year-old and threw his ass in the trash. Why are they not in the fucking Wild Hunnids?
No, we know that shit is, you know.
No, I'm just saying.
Oh, yeah.
They got bread. These children are dying because they don't got options.
It ain't about black people.
So, you go on their website and read their agenda. They trying to push the man out the house, and they want this shit that we see going on right now, where fucking Young and May is pushing baby carriages and all of that, and they looking at you like, you know what I mean? Like you did, I didn't do that to you, okay? I'm not the reason why you have not blossomed into a fucking flower, all right? You need to take that up with somebody else. So, there's some shit going on.
Yo,
there's some shit going on. We better get our shit together, because whatever administration comes in, it's only gonna trump up. And these niggas are gonna turn, they're gonna grow their wings, and they're really gonna turn into birds. They're gonna really sell us out. They're really gonna acquiesce. There was a chick online painting herself white as if that color means that you safe. These niggas are giving up more power to a fake fucking people, like I said, who's genetically your children. So I don't even want to be in a room with them. I'm not feeling no rappers right now, none of them. Because they have not come and funded anything that has been done on 120.
So you think with them putting on the on chains
car,
and
don't
doing
hop,
all that
fuck
shit?
That. Don't hop out
you
your.
You seen that,
don't
right?
Hop out your whip. Talking about I'm watching. Talking about I'm watching. I'm watching. Yeah.
He had the ark with a fucking Jesus piece.
Yeah. The ark with the Jesus pieces. Like, so a lot of these rappers.
Consciousness is commercialized.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Consciousness is commercialized. That shit is a fad right now. It's a bunch of mole. It's a bunch of bird niggas running around in Atlanta. The ark is homosexuality.
Are you serious?
Yes. In Atlanta, the ark is for the homos.
Nah.
It been like that.
Nah.
In Atlanta, the ark is a homo cross.
That's fucked up.
So all I'm saying
what the
is,
fuck?
If they never listen, it's 2016.
We'll edit that one out.
I've been on 2/5 for 10 years. With Sonetta, who you just saw.
Yeah.
You know what's crazy though?
None of these rappers ever came and said, yo, not only do we, remember these niggas get booked for 100 racks. Little Kim, Little Wayne, and all of the littles get booked for 100 racks to tell you how to hate yourself. 6 million ways to die. Them niggas will come with all six for you. None of them said, yo, I got 10 racks, 20, 30, 40. They went to Sue's. They went to fucking Lust and all of these other places.
Squandering their wealth.
Squandering amongst women who, to be honest with you, when they come and talk to us, they like, fuck them niggas. They not even interested in them. They only want your money because intellectually, you don't do what it takes that they want out of a real king. They come and bring the bag to us. All right? And I already told you niggas, if you came and spent $30,000 in your neighborhood and helped rebuild the same neighborhood that you destroyed, you could go into Lust and get a dance for free. They might even make it rain on you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay? They might even make it, they might throw the money on your bird ass. But that's not what they doing. Okay? That's not what they doing. So at the end of the day, I don't want to hear about no rapper. I don't want to hear about no actors. I don't want to hear about nobody until they put their money where their mouth is. On the dark web, they got websites where you can hire niggas to put in that work for you. What the fuck is wrong with you niggas? Huh?
That's crazy.
Bottom line, for everybody to be running around, why don't you put some loaves out there? Why don't you put some bread on the op? Until then, there's nothing to talk about.
Let's also realize there are double agents in every organization. So there are countless or a few brothers that are in these arenas that are doing shit on the low though.
Yeah, I know.
But the great majority of them are suckers.
We never want it. We don't need nobody to come and take no selfie with us. We don't need to sit at the table and do a press conference. It's called shadow investors.
Yep.
It's called secure the fucking bag.
You got a cousin.
When you
bring it to us.
What's always happened is that a lot of these artists, 5 and 10 years later, say, oh, I got robbed for my money. Come to find out, their financial advisor was an Israeli. Not a Jew, but a Zionist Israeli. So all of your money is being utilized against you. All of your money is being utilized your financial advisor is taking your money, your hard-earned money, and he is funding the war machine against the Palestinians, against the South Africans, against the African Americans, against everybody who you supposed to be helping. So I don't want to hear that. Y'all are retarded, damn near. Some of these people don't even know how to read.
Right,
and they got financial advisors taking their money and doing, and they will advise you.
Right.
Don't give your money to this black organization.
Right.
This black organization is seen as subversive. If anybody is subversive, you better run to them, because that means that they not bought out. That means that they have not been co-opted.
That's a fact.
All right? So, when is common sense gonna kick in? Y'all smoke too much weed to not have common sense. Y'all on too much drugs for this shit not to just come to you as common sense.
Yeah.
You drink too much bubbly to not fucking think straight. I don't get it. So, yeah, man. Clean up, man.
Yo.
Clean up. I promise you.
Phil, I was doing some research and, you know, I just ordered some, you know, products from Dr. Sebi, the Bromal Powder Plus and everything like that. But I was seeing somewhere on the internet where people were saying, you know, don't buy his products. Oh, certain people are in control of it and things like that. And I know you're very close and everything like that. You know, what could you tell the people who's out there actively buying the product?
I don't know.
Okay, okay.
What I won't say.
Okay.
What I would say is this. Sister Ma'a, Mama Pill.
Okay.
These are some of the people who, my mama, she was there to help him out at that time when he got co-opted.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, she has her business. There's formulas. These are apprentices.
Mm-hmm.
And
KT?
They have KT, the arts degree. These are apprentices of the good doctor. Sasa, Usha, Ma'a. Sebi had a lot of children as well. So there's other children out there that may be doing that as well. And he had a lot of apprentices. There's a brother that we have called Nati Congo. We bringing him out. He's a good brother from Jamaica. He got some fire with him.
Okay.
And what I'm saying is, all of them have products.
Okay.
And all of their products are effective.
Okay.
And all of their products work.
Okay.
And all of their products are coming from
the earth.
And they're coming from the knowledge, the pool of knowledge that Dr. Sebi possessed.
Okay.
But the same way that Michael Jordan won the ring, he didn't do it by himself.
Mm.
The same way that people get and you got all kind of things. The problem with our people is that they're dick riders. I'm sorry to use that language around you. The problem with our people are that they have a Judeo, like I said, they have a mind state where they are worshiper. They worship people and personalities, but they don't give credit to the teams that surround them. Those names go unmentioned because they are idol worshippers.
That's right.
So you don't want to talk about the team. Yes, Dr. Sebi did something monumental, but he did it in 1986. And I sat around 30 years and I watched my mama suffer, and I watched a lot of other people who are monumental and making history suffer. And you groveling ass Negroes don't know how to reward, and you don't put value into your own people. So when you begin to suffer, you niggas niggas start to cry. And we don't have remorse for you people that are out there crying because you don't care about your people the way that you say that you do.
All
right?
I got to say this, Red Bill. Oh, I got to say, Dr. Sabi had a lot of money with him, him and his man. So in Harlem and other places where the crew was at, they call it a gapper. He wouldn't give up the gapper to the police. Called the gapper.
Yeah.
He didn't want to give up the gapper. So they killed him because he didn't give up the gapper.
Damn.
Supremely corrupt, one of the most corrupt countries on the earth. Has a military regime in power, and they are the anti-nigger machine in Honduras is strong.
Wow.
They called him a witch doctor.
Wow.
They called him a witch doctor. They hated Sabi with a passion in Honduras.
Damn.
You're dealing with conquistadors. You understand? You're dealing with conquistadors.
So him curing AIDS is like crazy to them, scary to them.
It was witch doctor to them. They called him a witch doctor. They are Christians over there.
Mm.
So, you know,
so
at the end of the day,
he was doing the acts of the devil and shit
like
that.
Yeah, at the end of the day, I won't necessarily say not to get the herbs. You know what I'm saying? If they are not as strong, you know, I've had people say that they're not that strong. But I don't know because I didn't take them. I can't really co-sign that. You know what I mean? And I would say that my eyes in New York.
Okay.
She could be reached. The fig tree. Greenleaf-herbs.com is Mama Pill. Soionic.com is KT the Arch Degree. Seven Heaven Seamoss is Blue Pill.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Support the people who was with Sabi for decades upon decades upon decades. I'm about dealing with the team, the OGs. Day ones.
Mm.
I rocks with day ones. I'm about carbon, not facsimiles. I don't deal with spin-offs.
Just for the mere fact knowing that the money that you're investing is going to black hands should be enough for you to invest. Because we spend a lot of money with known enemies. So what's the problem in spending money with the people that were around the brother?
Remember, he
always gave credit to the people who blessed him with the knowledge. It don't come from him. Remember, he accredited
Mexican.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And other people.
The African woman
Mexican
in his life and all the others.
And mama and some African.
So whoever he showed love to and you know, showed respect to, if they're controlling what he created, pay like you wait.
Nah, that's real.
And I also feel
they can still eat fried chicken talking about, come on. Stop.
Yeah, but you know, there has to be accountability on all things that's taking place. So I would say, you know, let's have somebody that's in LA go down there and do the report for us.
Mm.
Like, figure this shit out. Because I'm in New York and I'm speaking about an office that I haven't visited in goddamn 15 years, damn near. I didn't go there in a long time. When I was in LA the last time, I tried to go, but time didn't permit it. So I wasn't able to drop by. But, you know, I know that my eyes out here. And she deserves your support. I know Mama Pill deserves your support. I know KT the Arch Degree deserves your support. I know Blue Pill deserves your support. I know that Usha deserves your support. Because this is about succession. This is about legacy, man.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And at the end of the day, they made African history. When is that shit gonna be valued? When are you gonna value that? When are we gonna, where's the bag for that one?
Benefit.
Mm. Yeah. Because now people gonna run around, we killed AIDS. We did this.
Mm.
Africa.
Yeah.
In the name of Dr. Sabi.
Mm.
But the real people on the team, yes, the real team players are not gonna get the credit. They're not gonna get what the resources. They're not gonna get what they need. Motherfuckers is gonna step into his shoes. They can't fill his shoes. They're gonna have their little 1 foot the size of his size 13 and try to walk in his shoes as if they did the work. You didn't do the work. You had nothing to do with that. You niggas wasn't in court. I got the fucking transcripts. Your name wasn't on the indictment. Fall back. Fall back. That's what happens in niggerdom.
Mm.
Niggas step in and try to make myths out of their contribution where they didn't contribute much.
Mm.
Okay? We have the names of the people who contributed them. Annette Thomas, Alethea Adams, Ma'a, Dr. Sabi, and there was a few others.
Mm.
You were not there. You were not part of that. You were not part of the motherfucking monumental case. You were not part of the landmark case. That's not your fucking legacy. Fall back. Okay?
Mm.
That's all I'm saying.
So, Red, like we had a lot of ancestors that, you know, passed away and things like that. You know, Dr. Fred
Creswell.
Yeah, like.
And all of their deaths are questionable.
Yeah.
Dr. Blair came to New York healthy.
Yeah,
he had a small ailment. They shuffled him around through house to house. He went to Chicago and died. Okay? No white man did that. okay? They didn't take care of him in New York and he died.
Well, what do you think, like, the people need to learn from all these great teachers who done came and drop all this information and now they're gone, you know what I'm saying? So some people
everything that's taking place with the Europeans could be traced to the ISIS papers, Dr. Francis Cress Wilson. Everything that's taking place on a health tip with these niggas running around in a zombie state could be traced back to what Dr. Sabi was trying to do for y'all. Mm-hmm. It starts at the health. Nobody who eats pork or fucking neck bones could tell me about nothing. I don't want to learn from niggas like that. Okay, that's what Dr. Sabi was banging. Hard body. Don't cover that part of his legacy up. Okay?
Yeah.
He threw 1,000 of the teachers under the bus for reasons.
Mm-hmm.
And these niggas be trying to paint over that. No, let that go. Mm-hmm. Let that fly. Yeah.
Honestly,
let that fly.
I knew the brother was in danger when he started to attack the quote-unquote veggies that a lot of vegetarians and vegans were promoting. When he started to attack them. Like cauliflower and broccoli, when you start to on some of
and
those
carrots?
Hybrid, you know, the hybrid
right,
vegetables
yeah.
and fruits. I knew
they
were
trying to kill him since the 80s when we was babies. I watched them get run out of New York by these bird ass niggas out here. These fake fucking teachers to be acting like, you know what I'm saying? That they down with no nigga. Stop that. Stop it. Don't do that.
Mm.
Guns will be, the cannons will go off. Don't do it.
Mm.
I watch the haters hate.
Mm.
So
from that era, man, that's what's needed.
Everything that you need to know, he taught you. And you could see the fallout from the people that didn't listen.
Yeah.
Dr. Blair told you about extraterrestrial life forms. He told you about your cosmic origins. He told you about all kind of things on a scientific level, a metaphysic, and an occult level. If any of you niggas running around saying that he's pseudo and all of these other things, you can eat a dick. You know what I'm saying? He did what the fuck he had to do.
Mm.
All right? And he's a legend. And he's one of the fathers of the conscious community. Mm. Keep in mind, what was taking place in Brooklyn in the late 80s and the 90s created what is known as the conscious community. It was different than what was taking place other places. The VHS movement, the big man in Shabazz started, and then it got passed on to other people. All right? Sonetta is in a succession of the DVD. Mm-hmm. Well, he brought forth the DVD. These brothers were VHS. He had VHS, but he's part of a succession of brothers and sisters who are disseminators of information. And mm-hmm. we gotta speak their name because it's about legacy. So you're not going to do what the European does, and that's called create their own fucking legacy or whitewash and reconfigure and repaint. No, niggas. No.
Making shit up.
Yeah, nah, fuck that. You're not gonna do that. All right? So, LIU, Long Island University, go and watch every single lecture or go and ask the OGs who were the men who stood on those stages. And whatever names you pull out of that bag, that's your conscious community. That's the beginning of the lecture circuit that revived because it was already on, it was already doing its thing and out here in academia, in City College, in other places,
mm-hmm.
Slave Theater. All of that, the O'Berry and Dempsey, all of that was functioning. All of that is a component and a part of the conscious community. All of that, those are the elders that Valentine and them were standing on. Those are the elders that that our master teachers were looking up to. But the master teachers were doing something on another level through LIU, going through, because they were talking about information that was not being talked about, like metaphysics, like the occult, like Moorish history. They were digging up information to complete the pieces of the puzzles that have been missing for a long fucking time.
Mm.
Okay? And there's thousands of DVDs out based on some of the work. And I'm not saying that only LIU, because Ajra Kwesi was waking people up doing his trips and stuff like that. There was Steve Coakley was in LA busting his gun. Del Jones, Amos Wilson, okay? So I'm not saying that it was only these brothers, but there was a production company. I opened a production, and there was Brother Big Man, and there was some other brothers, and that was a revival.
Mm.
When I say revival, I mean that all of these things were here, but there was a period when it died.
Mm.
There was a period when it died, and the revival came a little while before 9/11, and that shit really kicked in after the towers fell.
Mm.
And now we find ourselves right here. Pay homage, or K's vomit.
Mm.
You understand? Pay homage, or you'll be cursed. I don't gotta do nothing. the spirit that controls this community or whatever ancestors that move the pieces, they'll knock you niggas down. And I've seen you niggas get knocked down like bowling pins over my 10-year span. This shit is funny at the end of the day.
Yo,
I see niggas get you know Mario when you go from tall to a little guy and you need a mushroom to get back up. I've seen that shit happen.
It's a crazy metaphor right there.
Yeah, I seen that shit happen.
Yo, Pell, I've been seeing on the Black Magic 360 Rich channel and everything. He's been promoting the Black Power Awards and everything like that.
Yeah.
And I know you had a lot to do with it and everything like that.
I didn't have a lot to do with it. Well, I know. I just got nominated.
Okay.
I got called in to be a host.
Okay.
A co-host on the black carpet. The brother, I didn't get nominated for nothing for the record.
Damn.
I didn't get nominated for a team. And
did any of the brothers in the conscious community get nominated for anything? I mean, all the work y'all done put in, Polite, Seti's, you know what I mean? Nah.
Sa did, but
Sa
Rich got nominated. But we didn't know none of, you know, the new school, they call us.
Oh, okay.
You know, the brothers that are not on Hidden Colors.
Oh, okay. Shout out to Tariq. Okay. So it's more to the elders in a sense.
Well, elders, some new people, elders. I mean, the people who are, you know, deserving of their nominations from their nominees.
Because
the people were the ones who were voting, and then they had a committee to choose three nominees out of that. So, you know, it's interesting to, you know, see these new brothers, because some of these names were new to me.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to go and research some of these new names. And I come to find out that these brothers and sisters are doing work.
Okay.
So what I know is that sometimes, you know, work is being done and it's not being done with commercials attached to them.
Mm.
Or it's not being done in a limelight, you know what I mean? We can move towards a more light.
So far, what you, like the people you see nominated and things like that, do you feel everybody is deserving? Is it official for you? Like, is this an official Black Power Award to you? Like,
Black Power Award.
Yeah.
It's not the Conscious Community Award.
Okay.
It's Black Power Awards.
So there's a
difference. I'm in a conscious community, meaning that a component of Black Power is exposed, and I study it, and I build with the brothers that are part of it, but it's not all-encompassing.
Okay.
So the consciousness is not, that's a lane. Black Power Awards is a lane.
So that's two different things in a sense.
It would be remiss, it would not be honorable of me to speak of somebody not being qualified to be a part of the Black Power Awards when that's not my total lane.
Okay.
What I'm saying?
Okay,
I support that lane. I'm building that lane. I've contributed to that lane. You understand? But there are a lot of ponies in that race. The same way if they had a Moorish Awards. I don't know all the Moors. I'm not familiar with all the Moors. I haven't met all of them. I'm not sure about everything that's being done, because one thing about the Moors, they don't like the camera. It as it appears, they're not in the camera like that.
A real master will never get in front of the cameras, because they have too much to give and too much will be at stake. Mm-hmm. And believe it or not, we know these government agencies have devices that read energy, even through the camera.
Like on some Dragon Ball Z shit?
Nah, I mean,
you know how they have the eye that can read your energy?
They had the camera that takes your photograph that can read your aura.
My aura, yeah.
So technology is advanced.
Yeah.
So they can read your aura through the video.
They're infusing technology with spirituality or with magic. You understand? So someone who is super powerful, right? Someone who has ascended, would not ever get one in front of the camera. Matter of fact, once you reach that level of ascension, right? Because you never do nothing alone. When you ascend to that level, you have people around you all the time. We're not talking about physical folks, by the way. And they themselves will warn you about coming into the limelight. And that's how that goes. But I'm going to brother Bill on that, because he's a great
scholar. I mean, we live in a time where, you know, being clandestine and being under the radar could be more beneficial than being a fucking target. You know what I'm saying? Like, the administration is coming in, is going to approve drones on what they deem as their homeland threats. That's a given.
That's crazy.
That is a given. So they're gonna have ops. It's already been co-opted. I have a lecture called The Fear of a Blackamoor Messiah coming on Columbus Day, 10/10. I might do it at the Alhambra or Nicholas. And I'm gonna lay, it's 4 hours. Uninterrupted. I'm gonna lay this shit out. to show how they lining niggas all the way up. And this shit is coming, and it happened during the Obama administration.
Not only that, Brother Pill, right? We could go into something you were talking about earlier about the Moors selling out.
Uh-huh.
About Moors giving sacred information to the Europeans.
Yeah.
And that information being used against us.
Uh-huh.
Let's not forget, or let's not think for a second that this is not still happening.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
but they're recruiting math teachers all the time.
They're going to war against the Moors.
Uh-huh. Take a trip to Haiti.
If you go, if you go and tell any government official, or if you go and put any paperwork in and it says Moors on them, that is who the Christian church went to war with. They call them Muslims and stuff like that. Or they
that's what they call my-
they blanket and they call it Islam. But it's the Africans that were in Europe who, and the Arabs who were their cohorts that they went to war with. That's why they went into West Africa in the 1600s to finish the campaign. You got to read the papal bulls. The papal bulls are permission. It's the Pope giving permission of his armies to kill in the name of the cross and kill. It's a nigga. It's an anti-nigga campaign. So I didn't want to hear that dumb shit. Like, the Moors had the judges on the run. You niggas never have done, you have never impressed me in a courtroom, ever. The last time I was impressed in a courtroom with niggas who claim revolutionary was during the George Jackson era. Mm. Nothing has popped off ever since.
Outside of that, the only person that was impressed was Conor Ferguson.
Bunch of niggas I know is taking plea deals, and they got Jewish lawyers. Mm. The Moors had the police on the run. Remember when they had videos all on YouTube where the cops would stop people and they would shut him down. But that's not Moorish law, because there's a brother out there named Sean Thomas or Sean something on you. He's not a Moor. He knows his constitutional rights that you niggas should have been on.
Mm.
Okay? And people are gonna be like, it don't matter. You're gonna get shot. You sound like a victim. I don't talk to victims. Don't come around me. That's not cloth talk. You're not in your bag when you're talking like that. You sound fucking scary, all right?
Sound like a bitch.
You are actually magnetizing and bringing a situation such as that towards you.
I dig.
So no, get the fuck, that's copping out. No, niggas. Shut them niggas down. You tell them, you read them their rights.
Yeah.
You stand on your square and you make them prove who the fuck they are. Strap on the waistline. And that ain't even how I'm trying to go about it. I just don't leave home without it. Okay, it's go time. I'm the Lakers in this showtime. I ain't got a master cause I own mine. Ride shit, I'm on mine. Trap like Wi-Fi. Fees got it online. Got so many tools that I should go and build a shack. I ain't gonna stand with me. They got Paul George leg. And I'm banging on them like him. Smoking on him. Eating shrimp on the yacht. Coming to the mansion every war by Skiat. Yeah, money, we got a lot. My pack coming in on submarines. These niggas now they can't fuck with me. For every day I starve, nigga, I'm a feast. Every day it's young niggas dying in the streets. I know I run it up, but Lord, forgive me. No pun intended, I could walk on water. I ain't need no brown nigga, and this ain't the Carter. This is Dunbar, and I ain't telling all my brothers, nigga. And that's word to my mother, nigga. Yeah, shit, they say my city.